So friends, in this video, we will talk about the four kind of drugs which have their action on a very particular pathway in causation of the high blood pressure or hypertension. These are known as the drugs affecting the renin angiotensin aldosterone system. This is a very important system which is involved in causing the high blood pressure in majority of the patients. What happens in the renin angiotensin aldosterone system, which so famously is known as RAAS, R-A-A-S, which stands for renin angiotensin aldosterone system. Now, from our previous videos, we had seen that this renin, it is produced from the juxtaglomerular cells. Now, these juxtaglomerular cells, which are also known as JG cells, they are located at a very particular location. Now, this is glomerular capillaries. This is afferent and this is efferent arterioles. Now, along the afferent arterioles, there are certain cells which we call the juxtaglomerular cell. Juxtaglomerular cells are JG cells. Now, these juxtaglomerular cells, because of changes in the body, they secrete a hormone which we call renin. R-E-N-I-N. Now, this renin has got a very important function, and that important function belongs to one of the products of the liver. Now, liver produces a very important protein. Now, this is liver. It produces a very important protein which we call angiotensinogen. Angiotensinogen. Now, this angiotensinogen is broken down by the renin into angiotensin 1. Angiotensin 1. Now, this angiotensin 1 is produced from the angiotensinogen by its cleavage through the renin. Now, this renin can also be called as the angiotensinase. Angiotensinase, because it breaks down the angiotensinogen into the angiotensin 1. Now, this angiotensin 1 is converted into angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 with the help of a very specific enzyme which we call angiotensin converting enzyme. So, up till now we had seen two proteins or hormones. One is the renin and one is the angiotensin converting enzyme. So, finally when we had seen the production of angiotensin 2, this angiotensin 2 has very important function, which are: number 1, it causes vascular constriction or arterial constriction, and this is how it can increase the blood pressure. Secondly, it will cause the formation of the aldosterone from the glomerulosa part of the adrenal cortex. Now, these adrenal glands, they are sitting right on top of the both kidneys. Now, from this glomerulosa part of the adrenal cortex, which is the outer part of the adrenal gland, it produces aldosterone under the effect of the angiotensin 2. Now this aldosterone, it causes the distal convoluted tubule of the nephron. This is the distal convoluted tubule and this is the proximal convoluted tubule. Now this aldosterone, which was its production was increased under the effect of the angiotensin 2, which was formed from the angiotensin 1 with the help of angiotensin converting enzyme. Now this aldosterone causes increased reabsorption of the sodium and increased excretion of the potassium from the body at the level of distal convoluted tubule, and this will increase the blood pressure in the body and it will cause high blood pressure or hypertension. So those drugs which we are going to talk about in this video will be affecting this very system, which we call the renin angiotensin aldosterone system. There are four group of the drugs which we are to talk today. One is the one which will inhibit the renin. Second one are those who inhibit this very important enzyme, which we call the angiotensin converting enzyme. And those drugs will be known as angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. And on the third category will be the drugs which will be affecting those receptor where angiotensin 2 acts. Now this angiotensin 2, it acts on those receptor, and the drugs which block the effect of angiotensin 2 on the receptors are known as angiotensin 2 receptor blockers or ARBs. And lastly, the fourth group of the drugs are those which inhibit the action of aldosterone on its receptors in the distal convoluted and collecting ducts. Those drugs are known as aldosterone blocking drugs, are aldosterone antagonist. So these are four kind of a drugs which we are to talk. So
first of all, let's talk about the renin inhibitor.
Renin inhibitor. We had seen that renin causes the formation of the angiotensin 1 from the angiotensinogen. And this is secreted by the JG cells of the kidneys. A very famous drug in the renin inhibitor group is the aliskiren. Aliskiren, we give it in a dosage of 150 milligram once a day, and we can go all the way up to 150 to 300 milligram once a day. This is a very effective RAAS inhibitor, because the whole system of the renin angiotensin aldosterone starts from the action of the renin. If you block the action of the renin, you will block the production of angiotensin 1 and angiotensin 2. So those patients who are put on aliskiren, they have got high concentration of the renin and lower concentration of the angiotensin 1 and angiotensin 2. But unfortunately, up till now, this has not been in much use in the society, because there are more side effects and it doesn't work that well, though theoretically it should work better than the three preceding groups or following groups. So aliskiren should be given in a this dosage form, but it has got certain side effects. For example, one thing, it should not be given in the pregnancy. It is contraindicated in the pregnancy, and it can cause angioedema. It can cause kidney dysfunction. And it can also cause hyperkalemia and hypotension. So these are the side effects of the aliskiren. And that is the reason that if a patient is put on the aliskiren, and this patient doesn't get much benefit but develops side effects, so better option is not to use it. So this is the these group of the drugs is the ACE inhibitors, which is very, very famous. Angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, or ACEI. Now, as we had already seen that these are the group of the drugs which block the action of the enzyme, which helps to convert the angiotensin 1 into the angiotensin 2. So this enzyme is inhibited and these drugs decrease the blood pressure by using these action. But there are certain other actions, like these can also inhibit the degradation of the bradykinin, which is a vasodilator. These can increase the effect and production of the prostaglandins, which are again vasodilators. So that is, and these can also decrease the effect of the sympathetic nervous system. That is the reason even in those patients who have got lower concentration of the renin, these ACE inhibitors are very effective. What are the name of the drugs which we have as an angiotensin converting enzyme? And one thing which is very important, that these are used in combination with diuretics and calcium channel blockers in majority of the cases, rather than being used as the single or lone drug therapy. So the name of the drugs in the ACE inhibitors, these are captopril, lisinopril, perindopril, ramipril, fosinopril, enalapril, trendelopril, benazepril, quinopril, and moxipril. So these prils are the group of the drugs which are categorized as the ACE inhibitors: captopril, lisinopril, perindopril, ramipril, fosinopril, enalapril, trendelopril, benazepril, quinopril, and moxipril. But these have got their very important side effects, which we should all remember. And those patients who are put on the ACE inhibitors, in the majority of those patients, when they are put on the ACE inhibitor for the first time in their lives, it can cause hypotension in them. And a very important side effect is cough. It also causes dizziness. It can cause kidney dysfunction and hyperkalemia. A very famous side effect is also angioedema. These patients sometimes go on to develop taste alteration. They may also develop skin rashes. And these ACE inhibitors, they are contraindicated in the pregnancy. These are categorized as the category X. They should not be given in pregnancy because they can cause, and they do cause, the fetal anomalies in the second and third trimesters. And so patients need to be switched from this group to the next one. And why it causes, because of the bradykinesia, they can also cause a lot of other problems. And when bradykinin is inhibited, then these may also cause the angioedema. So this is the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor. Angiotensin 2 receptor blockers are very famously known as ARBs. Angiotensin 2 receptor blocker. We had seen that angiotensin 2 causes arterial constriction and also causes the increased formation and secretion of the aldosterone from the glomerulosa part of the adrenal cortex, which is the outer part of the adrenal gland, because the inner part is known as medulla, which is related with the formation of the catecholamines. So the famous drugs in the category of the ARBs, these are the Sartan's drugs. like valsartan, losartan, candesartan, telmisartan, olmesartan, irbesartan, aprisartan, and lastly azilsartan or azlisartan. So these sartans are the group of the drugs which we put under the banner of angiotensin II receptor blockers. Now these are, sometimes they are given in combination with the ACE inhibitors, but the studies have shown that giving them in combination can increase the side effect rather than giving relief. And certain studies have shown that losartan is not that much important, but valsartan has done a great job in the decreasing the blood pressure, especially in the white patient and young patients. So they get the most benefit out of the valsartan drug, which is a part of the ARBs. What are the side effects of the angiotensin receptor blockers? All those patients who develop cough as a result of ACE inhibitors, they better be put on the ARBs. These may cause hypotension, hyperkalemia, kidney dysfunction, and rarely they cause angioedema. Angioedema is very rare, because ACE inhibitors used to cause the angioedema because of the inhibition of the bradykinin. But angioedema is very rare when in those patients who are put on the ARBs. And these should never be given in the pregnancy. These are contraindicated in pregnancy. And studies have shown another very important thing, that those patients who are put on the ACE inhibitors and the ARBs, in them, especially if they are type 1 diabetic and they have a proteinuria, then their progression of the kidney dysfunction is halted or reduced when they are put on the ARBs and ACE inhibitors. Now, the doctors are so much used to prescribe these medication to stop the journey of the proteinuria nephropathy. Now there are certain group of the patient who are not hypertensive and they are put on ACE inhibitors and ARBs to decrease the progression of the proteinuria and nephropathy. So type 1 diabetic, type 2 diabetics, all of them are prescribed these aldosterone receptor blockers. Aldosterone receptor blocker. Now these are the drugs which block the action of the aldosterone on the receptor, and we had seen that aldosterone causes increased reabsorption of the sodium and increased excretion of the potassium from the body. What are the name of the drugs which are famous in this category? We had seen these drugs in past videos under the banner of the diuretics as well. These are spironolactone, amiloride, and eplerenone. Now these are not used as the first line therapy, but in majority of cases these are used as the add-on therapy. They are given in combination with the other drugs, because there are certain states which are concerned with the retention of the sodium in the body, for example heart failures and the cirrhosis. So these are the best drugs in combination to be given in these cases. But obviously these are not devoid of side effects or adverse effects. Now what are the side effects of this group of the antihypertensive medications? The side effects are the metabolic acidosis, because in the collecting duct there is excretion or secretion of the hydrogen ion. Now, those will be affected in a way that body or kidney retains the sodium and causes the metabolic acidosis. It can also cause gynecomastia. Gynecomastia in males, there is an enlargement of the nipple because of its effect on the progesterone receptor. Now, it happens more with the spironolactone and less with the apalurinone. This is gynecomastia. And lastly, it can also cause hyperkalemia. Our potassium goes higher than 5.5 millimole per liter, especially in those patients who has got a kidney dysfunction. And they also have a pre-treatment, or before the patient was put on these medication, if the potassium level was more than 4.5 millimole per liter, these patients can go on develop hyperkalemia, because aldosterone is very famous for excreting the potassium from the body. So when we obstruct the action of the aldosterone, then potassium goes on to develop in the body. It starts being retained in the body, and it will cause the hyperkalemia. And sometime we had seen patients who are known patients of the nephropathy, and they are put on the beta blockers, and they are also put on the ACE inhibitors and ARBs, and they are also taking potassium sparing diuretics or aldosterone receptor blocker. Then ultimately they come to the hospital with a complaint of dizziness, hypotension, and when we check their ECG, they are suffering from the complete heart block. And when we get their potassium, they are having potassium in the range of 7 to 8 or 8.5 millimole per liter. Then sometime we are to go for the hemodialysis, and sometime depotassium procedure is done to get rid of the high potassium in these patients. So that's all about the diuretics, and that's all about these kind of drugs which affect the renin angiotensin aldosterone system. Now, we had seen in these patients that these group of the drugs affect the renin angiotensin aldosterone system, which has four group of the drugs. One are the renin inhibitors like ali, squirin, and it affects the or inhibits the action of the renin on the liver produced angiotensinogen. Second group of the drugs are the one which affect the angiotensin converting enzyme, which causes the conversion of angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. The name of the famous drugs are the prils, like captopril, fosinopril, enalapril, perindopril, trendalopril, remipril, quercipril, moaxipril. So these are all the pril group of the drugs, which are known as ACE inhibitors. Now, the famous side effect of these are the cough. It can be dizziness, hypotension, kidney dysfunction, taste alteration. These can cause rash, and they may also cause the angioedema. Now, the second group of the drug is the third group of, in fact, is the angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, which we call the ARBs. These are the sartans group, like candesartan, telmisartan, olmesartan, losartan, valsartan, aprisartan, esleisartan. So these are the and irbesartans. Now, these are given especially in those patients who are intolerant of the ACE inhibitors because of the cough or angioedema. These rarely cause angioedema, but these can cause kidney dysfunction, hypotension, and hyperkalemia. Both ACE inhibitors and ARBs should be avoided in the pregnancy. So last group of the drug under this banner is the aldosterone receptor blockers. The famous one are the spironolactone, apalurinone, and amiloride. These cause the inhibition of the aldosterone. So it decreases blood pressure, shouldn't be used as a alone therapy, but this is used in combination therapy, especially in those patients who have developed the condition which retain the sodium, like nephrotic syndrome, cirrhotic patients and heart failure patients. Now, and the side effect of these drugs are the hyperkalemia, metabolic acidosis, and gynecomastia. So I hope it makes some sense of the this discussion, and I request you to please subscribe the channel, press the bell icon, like the video, share the video, and thank you so much for watching the video.